jobs and you got up early on a Saturday morning, join us on the beautiful Golden Gate Bridge for International Women's Day. So give us all an applause. Yay! This is our monthly coaching peace walk. We usually have it on the second Sunday. But, you know, International Women's Day is a really important day of the year. It's a day for women and supporters of women to come together for peace and justice and for equality for all women around the world and to support our right to live in peace wherever we live. And I want to thank this coalition that we have today, which is National Organization for Women. Yay! Woo! And we have Helen DeBossier. Thank you. You are so mouthy. Good for you.
Wonderful.
Helen Swanson is here today with us. She is initiating today the beginning of a year-long group trek across the United States of America to campaign for equal rights for women in the United States.
Equal pay.
Equal rights. And she is trying to get the ERA passed. Women for decades in this country have been fighting for an amendment to the Constitution to defend equal rights for women. Is it appalling in the 21st century that we still do not have the ERA amendment passed? Helen is going to be walking across the United States and next International Women's Day in 2015. Hopefully the ERA will be passed by then, because you can just campaign and visit all the representatives along the way in Congress to campaign for it. If it's not passed, I invite all of you to join her in her last days of a walk across the United States. She's planning to chain herself to the White House fence, and we should all support her efforts. Pass the word around. So thanks, Helen, and National Organization for Women. We also have Fukushima Response, and known as As many of you know, March 11th is the third anniversary of this terrible disaster in Japan. That happened 3 years ago and is really threatening the well-being of people in Japan. Many, many, many thousands are suffering, and it's threatening the well-being of this planet. And we're going to have them speak in a moment. And I want to give applause to the people working for environmental justice with those two groups and everyone. Give them all an applause. Yay!
No news!
No news!
No news!
No news!
No news! No news!
I also want to take note of Occupy SF Action Council, Occupy San Francisco Action Council, who's here today to support this awesome gathering. Give them a hand.
Yay!
And lastly, but not least, I want to thank my co-team brothers and sisters who come here every month. We've been doing it for over 3 years. To bring the message of peace every second Sunday at noon. And if you don't know about it, sign up on our list. We'll get you informed every month. They come up here no matter if it's rain or shine, and we walk on this beautiful bridge and give Kortink a hand for peace. If you didn't listen to KPFA today, I wanted to give a quick report back on the Gia Benjamin, the founder of Kortink. Many of you know she was brutally treated in Egypt while she was trying to cross, going to the border with a delegation of 100 women for International Women's Day. Is my voice being projected okay?
Yeah.
Peaceful activists, unarmed, traveling with 100 women, trying to go from Egypt, our ally, into Gaza to speak out for the injustice of women and children and men in Gaza who are living under the largest open-air prison in the world. And she was detained in Egypt for hours, thrown into a cell, spent the night there, no explanation. In the morning, several handful of men came in, no explanation, started carting her off through the airport to take her away. Ultimately, she got thrown on the ground, forced handcuffed brutally. Her wrists were injured, her shoulder was dislocated. Non-violent, peaceful woman. No explanation. In all those hours where she was detained, many, many people across the country and the world were calling the U.S. Embassy to get involved. The U.S. Embassy was silent to the abuse on Medea Benjamin. There's a reason for that. She was deported to Turkey, and without dislocating her shoulder, against the will of the doctors in the airport who were demanding that she not be put on a plane because she needed immediate medical attention. And, you know, she made it to Turkey. Luckily, there was a doctor who relocated her shoulder. Anyway, she's back, flown from Turkey to back to the United States in D.C. right now. She's safe. She's getting medical care. But of the 100 women, only 17 were able to actually enter Egypt, and 83 of the 100 were deported back to their original place of origin. This is a shame, and this is a country of Egypt, the government that we helped, this military coup that we helped install, we helped overthrow a democratically elected government in Egypt, and we give them billions of military aid every year. So I want to speak out against that injustice. I have a couple of things to say, but I know I've been talking way too long. So I'm going to move on and let the, by the way, Cortez is starting a new campaign to call for an end to all military aid to Egypt. So help get on board and support that effort.
Yeah.
And I say an end to all military aid of oppressive regimes around the world, including Bahrain and you know where else.
Israel.
Everywhere. All of them.
So, I now want to introduce Gina Brooks. Fukushima
United Kingdom
organization. Tell us and update us about Fukushima.
What's your name?
This is unacceptable for her and her child, just like it is unacceptable for the women in Japan who have lost their babies due to radiation exposure. It's unacceptable for them and unacceptable for us and all the children who are not yet born. Radiation is leaking from Fukushima every day and has been since the beginning. There's no end in sight. We need to work together in our own communities to prepare ourselves for the radiation that is going to gradually contaminate our lives too, in our oceans, our food, our air. This is why I've been working with Fukushima Response for the past 3 years. A mother from Japan sent me a link to her article. She describes her life with her family in Japan, and she offers three simple words for how she copes with her life. Learn, measure, avoid. She learns about radiation and how it works and the damage it does and how it circulates. She measures it to identify the dangers in her food and environment so she and her family can avoid the contamination as best as they can. We need to take it upon ourselves for our children to monitor our own environment. We can't trust the authorities to tell us the truth, and we can't wait for them any longer. We need to become empowered with information to help make decisions for our own families.
And I have a Geiger counter right here.
Thank you for listening to me, and I'm sure the women in Japan will thank you too. On Tuesday, March 11th, at Lydia's Sunflower Cafe in Petaluma, Fukushima Response will be creating an Ikebana ceremonial vessel in honor of the people in Japan. The vessel prayer will be launched into our Pacific Ocean, and you are all most welcome to join us. One ocean, one chance. It is time for us as women and mothers to do what we can to protect our families, our children, and their children. Thank you so much.
I believe that this world is a children is alive, and we need wonderful people like this today gathered here. But also, I think this world is filled with injustice. Most killings are justified by the name of the war. The question is, the suffering of women and their children. And also I think this world is filled with lies. Abe, Japanese Prime Minister, told to the world that Fukushima is under control. No, it is a lie. Fukushima accident is out of control. Many happening almost every day. Tons of water seeping, contaminated water seeping into underground water and into the Pacific Ocean. More than 140,000 people are relocating and are still living in temporary housing and are waiting for their better life. I want to mention the mother of Fukushima because today is the International Women's Day. These mothers of Fukushima are victims of this accident. But also, they are blaming for themselves to not able to relocate their children to safer place because they are living in the area which is not the mandatory evacuation area. They are not getting support, not compensation. So those families cannot afford to relocate. But these mothers know that area is dangerous of their children. They are blaming, they feel guilty themselves, so they are twice victims. And when the government raised the radiation danger level 20 times higher, so that the government says, these areas are safe. If you want, please relocate by yourself. Help by yourself. But many children are still living there with exposing day and day from outside and inside. But, yes, 74 children are diagnosed by thyroid cancer. So we know these children must be evacuated immediately. But I want to really mention many of those Fukushima mothers are stand up and then letting their voice out loud, telling the situation they experience. And then they are turning in justice. They go to Tokyo and giving the petition to government. They turn the dying heart around. And they are standing up. So those people I really want to honor. Mothers of Fukushima. Honor them, admire them. And I like to pray for those mothers and women and children of Fukushima victims. Now, Japanese government is forcing our nuclear power policy. The government will restart more reactors in Japan. This moment, there are none reactors operating under inspection and they are idling, but Japan couldn't. Tokyo doing all right without any nuclear power. We like to continue to have no nuclear power operating in Japan. Japan government said nuclear power is less expensive compared to other source. No. It is very expensive if the Fukushima accident like it happened. So much money has poured into, but this cannot contain after 3 years. It need ongoing assistance. And the government says nuclear power is reliable. No.
These are so actually day 2015, that's March 8, 2015, that will be a Sunday. She's inviting everyone to join her that day. The ERA has not been ratified yet. So I'd like to introduce just for a quick moment Summer Lowen, who's the San Francisco Now president, and then she will introduce Helene.
Hey, Summer!
Hey, Summer!
To bring out here today to show signs of coalition, different issues and actions that are all obviously loaded for women and our empowerment in society. We definitely need the ERA. We need more action on a national level as we see more and more targeted attacks against women's rights for reproductive health care. We see a new glass ceiling emerging in San Francisco with tech companies and the misogyny that unfortunately goes along with a lot of that. And we just need national action. So it's really wonderful that we're all here today. And I wish Helene the best of luck on her walk. We'll be there to support her every step of the way. And without further ado, here you are.
Hello, everyone. I just want to say thank you all very much for being here. I think everybody here has expressed how important all of our issues are. And there's not one issue that does not affect the entire. We live as a white man who changed my life in India. I hope that I too, like a little small white ant, will cross this country, and that all together we will move this great nation forward in changing the world on a global level. And no matter what you believe, if you're a non-believer, that's okay. I'm okay with that. I've been there too. But I'm an evangelical vegetarian, and I'd like to thank God for this moment. May she continue to rain down her glorious rays.
Thank you, sir. It's been almost 100 years since Alice Paul wrote the original Equal Rights Amendment. Let's see it happen in our lifetime.
Do you even need a equal rights amendment?
She can't serve the gift of the blessing.
Hello, everyone. This is a very short and very feminist liturgy. We have this blessing. Do people have
Helene, who will be here with us in spirit today, and will be here now and on every step of Helene's journey. So, along, we start with the gathering on the inside page. When it says all, that's you guys. When it says leader, that's you. In the beginning, before time, before people, before the world began, God was. And after God birthed all of glorious creation, God created humankind in her own image. Woman and man, she created them. Equal, she created them. God blessed them and said, it is good.
Oh, yeah. Elaine, here.
Right.
Okay, she's right here with her. Look, look,
here you go. I'm going to turn around.